Hi everyone, welcome to the lab. This time I have a big flat screen TV for repair. Sorry, it looks like a black hole, I cannot even show it very well right now. It barely fits on my bench, I have a small lab. I cannot even move the camera back anymore, because there is another bench right behind me. Anyway, this is 50-inch Toshiba HD TV. Quite recent, very thin, very light, with LED backlight, not bad at all. Someone tossed it out, because it has a problem, and I picked it up, because I'm interested in such things, and I could use something like this myself. It was tossed out without a remote, but I keep a box of remotes, and I found this Toshiba remote with the DirecTV logo on it. Apparently it can control DVD, VCR, TV and satellite, and it happens to work with this TV. It takes a little while to power up. There you go, and I plugged in this Samsung Blu-ray player. The TV should detect the right input in a moment. Come on, oh there you go, HDMI 3. And everything looks just fine. But after a while, the LED backlight starts blinking, and that's the problem. So it seems that the LED driver is faulty. Here is the problem. I waited for a while and it started blinking. So let's take this thing apart and have a look. Here is the back of this thing. The model is 50L3400U, April 2014, 6 years old. Let's see what do we have here. Network connector, 3 HDMI connectors, optical digital audio output, analog component video input, analog audio input, antenna input, USB here, and a few buttons to control this thing without a remote. One screw is missing here. I wonder if someone has been inside before me. The cover is off. And look, this bunch of wires is not under this piece of tape. Is this another sign that someone might have been inside? Anyway, let's have a look. This is the main board. This looks like a Wi-Fi module. And this is a power supply with LED driver. We should focus on this thing, I suppose. Let's take a look at this power board. We can see this isolation gap between the primary side and the secondary side, with some transformers and optocouplers across the gap. And I looked up this model. This seems to be a known problem. I'm not sure if it's a widespread problem, but at least it is discussed. There must be an LED driver chip under this heat sink, and most probably it is faulty. And the chip, as I understand, is not from a major manufacturer, at least it is not available through reputable distributors like DigiKey or Mouser, but it is sold all over eBay and AliExpress for just a few dollars, so it seems to me this should be easily fixable. Here is this power board removed, so we can take a closer look at it. There is a mark in here, and also next to this connector. It seems like this chip has 4 channels, and each channel is 55 volts, 240 milliamps. And there is a hot spot here, apparently, because the board is discolored, and sure enough, on this side, we can see this power device, and it seems to be involved in the power rail for this chip. And this chip is a 16-pin package. Let's see, is it visible? A little bit. So this heatsink goes under the chip, and this goes over, obviously. So let's remove this heatsink to have a closer look. I managed to desolder this heatsink, And this is a thermal glue, not that thermal compound which always stays soft. This is hard. And there is some discoloration around the chip, so it must have run quite hot. But there is no special heat sinking on this package, just a plastic package. And I'm almost sure that there is no heat sinking pad on the bottom of it as well. We can make sure after desoldering it, of course. Sure enough, just a regular plastic package, as I thought. I don't like this very much. It seems like inadequate thermal management for this chip and for that power device on the other side. No heat sinking pads on the chip itself, but then such a massive heat sink around it. It doesn't look serious, does it? And I'm not sure why. I used to think that Toshiba is quite a serious shop. And perhaps this module is not produced by Toshiba, but by some partner. I don't see any brand name here, but this looks like some logo, but I'm not sure what it is. I'm not familiar with it. But anyway, Toshiba must have approved it and decided to put into their product. Looks like an extreme cost cutting to me. Here it is, OZ9998HDN. Here is a datasheet, the power of efficiency, intelligent lighting. O2 micro, I've never heard of this before. And here, under LED backlight controller ICs for monitor applications, we can find this OZ9998H. 4-string high-power LED controller. Page 20. Let's take a look at page 20. Here it is. High-power DC to DC boost converter controller. Up to 4 high-power LED strings. Optimized for high-voltage drive output. Integrated transistors. External PWM dimming. Power MOSFET over current protection. Short circuit and open string protection, thermal protection, high efficiency, high power LED driver controller optimized for large size LCD monitor and LCD TV applications, integrated with high voltage MOSFET driver, and so on, and a fuzzy application diagram. Is this the power device which also runs hot? And that's it. There's another chip after that. Here it is on eBay for about $2 a piece plus $2 shipping from China. I will place an order and it will take a while to arrive. My order has arrived. I bought a couple of chips just in case, and I also bought this thermal glue. So I will scrape off the old one, apply some new one, put the chip in, solder the heat sink, and then solder the pins of the chip. New chip is fitted. Let's give this a go. This thing is running for quite some time and not blinking, so it seems like a successful repair. But I'm interested to see how hot is this heat sink. It is quite hot to the touch, so let's measure it. -63°C already. 64. And this is a chip in a plastic package. I wonder how hot is the die inside of this chip. The plastic is not transferring heat very well, I suppose. Around 66°, I've seen. I don't like this very much. Doesn't seem like a good design to me. So, this thing is running for about an hour, no problem so far. before it started blinking in a couple of minutes. So it must be fixed. I'm not sure how long it will last, but I have a spare chip just in case. Thanks for watching. Bye.